is Dr. Buhushan from NMC Royal Hospital in DIP. He is a specialist in oral surgery, including maxillofacial. Doctor, how are you doing this morning?
Good morning, Ronak. I'm doing very well. How are you?
I'm very good, sir. पहले तो आपको 75th Republic Day की ढेर सारी बधाइयाँ.
सबको बधाइयाँ, आपको भी बधाइयाँ और अपने सारे listeners को भी बधाइयाँ.
जी जी जी, बहुत ही अच्छा दिन है. एक तो Friday है. हाँ. इंडिया में तो मतलब टोटली बहुत दिनों से एक ऐसा समा चल रहा है जैसे कि वेकेशन शुरू हो चुका है दिवाली वाला, क्योंकि पहले इट वाज दिस वीक इज बीन लाइक दैट,
इट हैज बीन,
क्योंकि अयोध्या में दे हैड द मंदिर ओपनिंग एंड नाउ टुडे इज द रिपब्लिक डे एंड इट्स द लॉन्ग वीकेंड ऑफ कोर्स. ग्रेट, सो व्हाट बेटर देन स्टार्टिंग द वीकेंड विथ सम टिप्स ऑन हेल्थ, एस्पेशली ओरल हेल्थ, जो बहुत मुझे लगता है कि एक निग्लेक्टेड चीज है. आपको लगता है एज अ डॉक्टर दैट इट इज नॉट स्पोकन अबाउट एज मच एज इट इज नीडेड?
या आई डेफिनेटली फील कि अब हमको ओरल कैविटी के बारे में ज़्यादा अपना ख्याल रखना चाहिए, क्योंकि इफ़ यू लुक एट इट, इट्स द मेन गेटवे फॉर आवर बॉडी. लाइक आवर नोज इज फॉर द एयर, वी टेक आवर फूड, आवर drink and everything, and it plays a very important role in our overall health maintenance. So I think we should be looking more about oral health and try to take good care of it. So I definitely agree with you.
जी, तो आप कौन से specialties में आप deal करते हैं? If you can just tell us the scope of your specialization.
Ronak, I am basically what we call as an oral and maxillofacial surgeon. So, हमारा training दोनों dental specialty में as well as medical specialty में होता है. And we are like a bridge or a link between the dental and the medical specialties. So, हमारा काम mainly it is dealing with problems related to the tooth. When we have to do a surgical extraction or there is a tooth fracture, we also deal with fractures of the jawbone, of the facial bones like nose, orbits. Sometimes we even collaborate with the neurosurgeons whenever there are massive skull fractures. Apart from that, we also look into pathologies that are related to the oral cavity. Pathology matlab jaise tumors hai ya cancers hai, which are related to the jaw bones, cheek, अपने जो cheek and tongue, ये सब हम deal करते हैं.
जी, so it won't be wrong to say that your scope of work is far bigger than a dentist's.
Yeah, we look at much more different aspects in the overall health management as compared to dental doctors, who are mainly looking after the teeth, like the cavities, fillings, gum problems. So we go a little beyond them.
Okay. So aap maxillofacial surgery bhi karte hain.
Yeah.
So what exactly is that?
It is, maxillofacial is actually, if you translate it in lay terms, it is the surgery of the jaw bones. Okay, jo hamara upper jaw hai, lower jaw jisko hum mandible kehte hain, और अपर जॉ जो हम मैक्सिला बोलते हैं. सो इसमें काफ़ी सारे प्रॉब्लम्स आते हैं, जैसे सिस्ट होता है या ट्यूमर होता है, बिनाइन ट्यूमर, या इनके कैंसर्स होते हैं. ओके, एंड देन इनके फ्रैक्चर्स होते हैं, और समटाइम्स दे आर माल अलाइंड, मतलब वो सही पोजीशन में नहीं रहते हैं. तो उनको हम सही पोजिशन में लाते हैं, उसको हम ऑर्थोग्नैथिक सर्जरी बोलते हैं. सो this is basically the wide scope. Aur iske alawa hum also, there is something called as a temporomandibular joint or jaw joint. So uske kafi sare problems hote hain, jaise arthritis ya baki ke issues. So wo usko bhi hum deal karte hain.
Okay, so it mainly deals with jaws.
Yeah, mainly with the jaw bones.
Okay, but not with the rest of the face.
फेस में ऑर्बिट्स भी हम डील
करते हैं. ऑर्बिट्स,
ऑर्बिट्स इज द बोनी पार्ट ऑफ द आई.
ओके,
ओके, द बोनी सॉकेट ऑफ द आई. सो जहां पे भी बोन इन्वॉल्व होता है फेशियल रीजन में, उसमें हम
ओके पूरे फेस में, दैट्स व्हाई इट्स कॉल्ड मैक्सिलोफेशियल सर्जरी.
मैक्सिलोफेशियल सर्जरी, मैक्सिला बेसिकली मींस द जॉज एंड फेशियल, यू नो,
द एंटायर फेस. ओके, सो व्हाट काइंड ऑफ patients come to you and what kind of problems do they present to you mostly?
The major work that we see is trauma, kyunki hum kafi करीब है ये E11
को DIP,
और या और इंडस्ट्रियल एरिया से. सो काफ़ी सारा ट्रॉमा आता है जहाँ पे फेस पे इम्पैक्ट रहता है आइदर ड्यूरिंग वर्क या रोड ट्रैफिक एक्सीडेंट्स में. सो उसका डील करते हैं. उसके अलावा बिकॉज माई एरिया ऑफ स्पेशलाइजेशन इज़ कैंसर, सो आई डू डू अ लॉट ऑफ ओरल कैंसर्स हियर एज वेल एज बिनाइन पैथोलॉजी, मतलब जो ग्रोथ रहता है बट वो कैंसरस नहीं रहता है.
ओके
वो भी मैं
डील करता हूँ. डिसफिगरेशन ऑफ द फेस,
या डिसफिगरेशन हो जाता है तो वो भी डील करते हैं.
ऑल राइट, इट्स अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग you know, discussion, and we haven't had this in detail, so we'd like to know more about this. If you want to join in the discussion, 0586-86-1003 is the number where you can WhatsApp. If you want to take a consultation, if you are having any problems with your oral hygiene or oral care in terms of your facial issues as well, if you are looking for a maxillofacial surgery as well, 800-81003 is the toll-free number to have a consultation with the doctor free of cost in this hour.
If I should stay, I would only be in your way. So I'll go, but I know I'll think of you every step of the way. And
This is Life Talk with Ronak Koteja. Talk 100.3.
11:13, a very good morning. This is Ronak Koteja on Life Talk, and with me is Dr. Buhushan. He is an oral surgeon specializing in maxillofacial surgery. Now, doctor, the thing is with oral surgeries and oral problems, what are the myths that you generally come across? What do people not know about that they should know?
Yeah, one of the main things that I get from the patients who come to me is that, we have not heard of this specialty at all. And I would say it's a little unfortunate that we are not as well publicized as many of the medical specialties. That is the first thing. The second thing they feel is that if they undergo any surgeries on the face, they will be deformed, they'll be disfigured. But I'll tell you very honestly, Ronak, we have come a very long way. And now the surgeries are being done with very minimum incisions. And we try to preserve facial aesthetics to a large extent. And people, after the surgery, after about, say, 2 weeks or so, don't even look like that they have undergone surgeries. And the third thing is, which I get very commonly, is, Dr. Saab, hum khana kha sakte ki nahi? Everybody is worried that if they get a surgery of the face or the mouth, then they can't eat and there will be a lot of food restrictions and things. But abhi aisa kuch nahi hai. There are certain, yes, exceptions to this, but overall, within a week, 10 days, patients are returning back to normal life. So, wo jo unme scare hai normal life. So, wo jo unme scare hai ki how long will I be out of work or out of this thing. Wo abhi
out of public life also.
Yeah. Out of socializing, out Correct. Of this thing. So, I think that is one of the biggest scares people have. But I think with the newer techniques, newer advances, we get back people to moving on with their life
pretty quickly.
Right. Yeah.
No, I understand, you know, people have reservations about this because jab bhi baat aati hai face ki ya eyes ki, to log zyada sensitive hote hain because that's the one area that is always open and people, it's there for people to see. And it's very normal to be very conscious about that.
Definitely, because it's the main thing that gives you the identity. So,
correct, it's the identity. Yeah. It's your, that's what you carry along with you. But you said that, you know, people don't know much about it. You worked in the UK, you worked in Scotland, Wales, England. Is it the same there as well? How different is your field there when compared to here?
Over there, it is a little more organized because majority of the treatment goes through the NHS. So there are different, I would say, a definite referral patterns. So people get referred for the problems of this to.
So you mean when the department?
Yeah.
Right. So when the patients come to you, they have already gone through that sensitization. Okay, now why they are coming to you?
Yeah.
In a general scenario, when people come to you, they probably are always referred by others or they directly come to you?
Majority of our practice is referral, and one of the most common this thing is the dentists who refer to us.
Okay.
They are the ones who know about us more.
Correct.
Than the
general public, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So, since you said that you are a surgeon of the face, you know, does that become cosmetic and is it then covered under insurance?
If you look at surgeries which involve like correction of the jaw deformity and all that, they are a bit in the gray area because the insurance can sometimes say, no, this is cosmetic.
Right.
Though a lot of times it is functional because of which the patient is not able to talk well or chew well, is getting pain. But that's a gray area. But rest of it, like the tumors, the cancers, the trauma, they all get covered under insurance.
Okay. So if somebody has a deformity, like the nose, would that be under you, like a septal deviation or something?
No, septal deviation, we don't. That would go under the ENT. Okay.
Right. Okay. Yeah. Let's also, once again remind our listeners that the number to message is 0586861003. Dr. Bhushan is going to be with us for this hour. So if you have any questions regarding oral surgery, oral hygiene, we'll talk more about that, about misconceptions and myths as well. Send in your questions if you want to speak to him. 8008-1003 is the WhatsApp. It's the toll-free number.
Life Talk 100.3 Talk Music, brought to you by insurancemarket.ae.
Everybody needs a little time away. I heard her say, from each other, even lovers need a holiday. Ooh, yeah. Far away from each other. Hold me now. It's hard for me to say I'm sorry.
InsuranceMarket.ae now has over 20,000 Google reviews, the highest rated and the largest insurance platform in the country. InsuranceMarket.ae.
This is Life Talk with Ronak Koteja. Talk 100.3.
Right, it's 11:22. A very good morning. This is Ronak Koteja, and with me is Dr. Bhushan. He is an oral surgeon from NMC Royal in DIP. Doctor, some questions are coming in. So the one question that has come is from Hussein. He's asking, what is the best food for the face to look young? Is it something that you get a lot?
People do ask. But as far as the theory goes and this thing, there's no one particular food which will keep your face young. But what I would suggest is like what all doctors tell. All healthy diets which are balanced with a good amount of protein, some amount of carbohydrates, fats, vitamins, keeps the face young and makes you look healthy.
Right.
Okay, so, but I mean, if you ask me for one particular food, I don't think there's any any one particular food that would change your facial appearance.
Okay, yeah. But you know, aaye din hum dekhte Instagram par itne zyada, you know, people have become beauty experts from nowhere. Suddenly they've woken up one morning and decided to do that. So itni sari cheeze aati hai ki aap ye laga lo, ye wala lep laga lo, ye wala concoction bana ke pee lo. So how much do you read into these kind of videos?
I mean, I am aware that a lot of this material comes, but what I would like to make it clear is isko koi piche theoretical background nahi hai. There is no evidence-based this thing ki aap kuch ek particular karo to aapka beauty ho jayega. Yeah, these do help in complementing to your skin texture and appearance. But isse aap pura ye change ho jaoge, ye kehna bahut hi mushkil hai.
But general, agar hum dekhe, to face ki, because you work with, you're a facial surgeon. So what are the regular precautions, like, you know, washing the face and stuff like that? Some people wash their face so many times in a day. Some people say ki nahin, only twice a day is fine. Me personally, I wash it only twice a day. Once in the morning, once in the night.
Yeah, I think unless you are working in an environment which is very dusty, or your face is smeared with dirt and things like that, two times washing properly with soap, drying it, and in cold season using
soap.
Any form of cleanser or soap.
Okay, yeah.
But
soaps are generally very harsh on facial skin, at least. Do you think the facial skin is different from the rest of the body?
No, the facial skin is almost similar as the rest of the body. Yeah, and there's nothing special about it.
Really?
You need to take general care like what you take for the skin after this thing. Yes, of course, if you're out in the sun and things like that, then there is a chance that it becomes more darker than the rest of the body. So that is what you need to be careful about, that when you go out in the sun and things like that, you need to protect
sunscreen,
your face.
Because in this part of the world. Yeah. Also, one thing, since we're talking about, you know, face, a lot of doctors come to me here and they say that vitamin D deficiency is very high in this region, despite us being a very sunny country over here. So, we use a lot of sunscreen. Does that also cause vitamin D deficiency, according to you?
No, I don't think the sunscreen will make a huge difference. It's just that we don't go out more in the sun because it's quite hot. So that is what causes the deficiency. But otherwise, the sunscreen per se don't cause much vitamin D deficiency.
All right. Yeah. But aap keh rahe ho ki facial skin jo hai wo same baki skin ke jaise hi hoti hai. Then why do we get all these acne and all of these things on that skin more?
One is because we have hair follicles on the skin more than this thing. And second, the skin is more exposed as compared to the rest of the body. So the chances of accumulation of dirt and the bacteria and all that is much more with regards to the facial skin.
Okay. But you can use the same care for the facial skin that you use for the rest of the body, like the same soap or the same cleanser or all of those things. Can you continue doing that?
Yeah, you can use it. There should not be much of a difference in this thing. Some people are allergic to certain kinds of soap, so they need to take care and not use them. Some of them which come with certain chemicals are not very
good for
the skin overall. So those things need to be avoided.
All right. Okay, one more thing that, you know, is very important over here, beyond, of course, your facial features and the taking care of the skin, is also oral cancer. Now, how rampant is it in this part of the world?
Fortunately, it is not as rampant as in some of the other countries. Okay, one is because people, the use of tobacco is quite limited, like chewing tobacco or pan and all that is quite limited over here.
Okay.
But of course, smoking is on the higher side.
True.
So one of the most common causes of oral cancer is the tobacco usage.
Smoking.
Yeah, smoking, and along with that, alcohol. So that combination is not really very good for the oral cavity, and that's one of the main reasons why people develop oral cancers.
Right. And also one thing here, since you said smoking, is of course always going to be a problem, you know, when it comes to health. But a lot of people do vaping over here. They think that it's less harmful. So what do you have to say about that as a doctor?
No. The vaping, the electronic cigarettes all have a similar propensity towards this causing the cancer. And it has been shown in literature that they are no different than the use
smoking,
of a cigarette.
Yeah. Right. And what about shisha?
Shisha also has a higher risk, but compared to cigarettes, it's a little less if you don't use tobacco.
Okay.
People use other substances in shisha, so that is a little more risky, but
lesser of an evil, let's
just
say.
lesser evil, yeah. That's how I would put it. Yeah.
Right, but you know, the kind of problems that people come to you with when it comes to oral surgery and oral cancers, so which is the... In this part of the world, which is the maximum, you know, reason that you get because of that?
The most commonest reason is tobacco.
Okay.
And alcohol. But we are also seeing patients who don't have any habits who are developing cancers. And now it has been well proven that certain viral infections, like the human papilloma virus, which causes cancers in ladies in the cervical region. So some viruses of the same family, if prevalent in the oral cavity, also can cause cancer. So we are seeing people without habits also who develop these cancers. And one of the major cause for that is the viral etiology, I mean the viral cause. And apart from that, many other reasons, I mean the viral cause. And apart from that, many other reasons are there, like a sharp tooth, which is irritating a part of the tongue or a part of the cheek for a long period. Then some people wear a very ill-fitting dentures or teeth. And that is also a known cause for causing cancer. And we have seen people who develop the cancer because of a sharp tooth, which is constantly irritating the tongue. So if any such things are there, they need to be looked into quite quickly and then treated as per the need.
A sharp tooth can cause cancer. I mean, that's quite a revelation, actually. So what does that tooth do? Like, it keeps injuring, injuring the skin of the tongue?
Yeah, it keeps injuring the mucosa, what we call. So constant irritation is not good for any part of the body. And especially the oral cavity, which is very sensitive.
Right.
So over a period of time, the body develops a defense mechanism. It may not be very painful, but usually they end up having a white patch on the tongue or on the cheek, wherever it is damaging. And if left for very long time, this can turn cancerous and can be quite a big problem for the patient.
Okay. And when, you know, when you're taking care of your oral hygiene, do these also count, you know, when it comes to contributing to something as grave as oral cancer? Like, for example, not, you know, brushing twice a day, or like, you know, not taking care of your tongue, not cleaning it enough, those kind of things, because we take it for granted all the time.
Like I said, one of the causes is the oral viruses. I mean, if you are regular brushing your teeth, using some form of a mouthwash to keep the oral cavity clean, it definitely helps in reducing the risk. But per se, I mean, if you don't brush and all that, whether it causes cancer, it's
a very
difficult.
Broad statement, and I don't think... Yeah, but what I meant to ask you is that oral hygiene is very important, you know, for obviously for your social purposes as well. But it doesn't directly lead to something as grave as oral cancer, but it can aggravate the situation.
Yeah,
if you
it
have
can
a
definitely contribute to the if you have the other risk factors, then it definitely contributes to the
right. It's very interesting because yesterday was the National Fluoride Day, and I had one of the dentists on call with me, and we were talking about how important it is, and she was explaining that, you know, for children there is a certain amount of fluoride you have to look on your toothpaste and stuff like that. So you know, when I mean, since you also deal with oral hygiene and oral care, is there anything that we should keep in mind when it comes to our oral health?
Yeah, I mean, if you first of all, what my advice would be is to have at least an oral checkup done once in 6 months to a year's time.
Okay, with a general dentist?
With a general dentist. And if you notice any an ulcer is like a wound or ghav, which is not healing, jo bhar nahi raha hai, ek hafta, do hafta nahi bhar raha hai, ya aap koi white patch dekhte ho, या आप कोई ऐसा गांठ देखते हो, या यू सी अ लंप इन द टंग और लिप और एनीथिंग लाइक दैट, इट्स बेस्ट टू इन्वेस्टिगेट इट अर्लियर रादर देन वेट फॉर इट टू कॉज अ प्रॉब्लम. बिकॉज वन ऑफ द गुड थिंग्स इज इफ यू कैन पिक अप एन ओरल कैंसर वेरी अर्ली ऑन, देन यू कैन गेट एब्सोल्यूट 100% क्योर. एंड वी हैव गॉट पेशेंट्स हु हैव बीन डिसीज फ्री एंड आर लीडिंग नॉर्मल लाइफ्स आफ्टर 5-7 ईयर्स ऑफ ओरल cancer treatment.
Okay.
So it is definitely treatable and curable. So earlier detection is what
like
you would suggest.
In any cancer for that matter.
Yeah.
But are these oral cancers also fatal?
Yeah, they can be fatal. I mean, if left for too long and if they go into areas wherein they can, because once it leaves the oral cavity, either it will go in the neck or it can go towards the skull, that is the base of
the
skull.
The neural part then.
Yeah. So then
that
they can
be very grave.
Very fatal.
Right. Also, two questions have come in. I'll take one. Sajid is asking, can I eat or drink after oral surgery? See, again, the kind of same questions that you get, I guess.
Yeah, I mean, we won't starve any of our patients.
Right.
But the type of diet changes, like you may have to go on a soft diet or a liquid diet, depending upon what type of surgery you do. But gradually, we make it a point to see that you come back to your normal diet in about a week, 10 days' time. And again, like I said, it depends from different surgery to surgery. And I mean, definitely, there's no surgery wherein we would starve our patients.
Correct, yeah. Kuch nahi to, at least drip to hoga hi, of course. Like extravenous though would be there. I mean, in case you can't, the surgery is so complex that you can't open your mouth, for example.
Yeah. So, us time pe hum, we put what is called as a nasogastric tube. So, nose mein se stomach mein tube dalte hain.
Oh my God. Aur us mein se, painful and quite irritating.
Yeah, it is a little difficult, but it's not done for all the patients. It's only certain category of major surgeries.
All right. Okay, one more question I want to ask you is from Jasmine. She's asking, is there any cure for TMJ arthritis? By TMJ, I think it's tongue, mouth and jaw?
No. It is the temporomandibular joint. Yeah, there are treatments for TMJ arthritis. Like if you're not getting well with conservative treatment, like soft diet, analgesics, muscle relaxants, then there is something called as an arthroscopy, just like what you do the arthroscopy for your knee or other joints. So you can do arthroscopy for the TM joint and see what the problem is. And nowadays we have even joint replacements for temporomandibular joint, like what you have for knee or hip joint. So that's the worst case scenario. But definitely, yes, TMJ arthritis can be treated and people can get back to normal thing with the pain-free life.
All right. Yeah. We'll continue talking with Dr. Buhushan about this very interesting but very important topic as well, which is oral care and oral surgeries. Join in the discussion, 0586861003. That's our WhatsApp number.
The smooth music and live talk with Ronak Koteja. This is Talk 100.3.
I've heard people say that too much of anything is not good for you, baby. But I don't know about that. There's many times that we've loved and we've shared love and made love. doesn't seem to me like it's enough. It's just not enough, baby. It's just not enough. Oh, baby.
My darling, I can't get enough of your love, baby. Girl, I don't know why I can't get enough of your love, baby. Lord, some things I can't get used to, no matter how I try. It's like the more you give, the more I want. And baby, that's no lie. Oh, no, babe. Tell me, what can I say? What am I gonna do? How should I feel when everything is you? What kind of love is this that you're giving me? Is it in your kiss or just because you're sweet? Girl, all I know is every time you're here, I feel a change. Something moving. I scream your name. Look what you got to do with, darling. I can't get enough of your love, baby. Girl, I don't know why I can't get enough of your love, baby. Oh, no, baby. Girl, if I could only make you see and make you understand. Girl, your love for me is all I need, and more than I can stand. Oh, well, babe, how can I explain all the things I feel? You've given me so much, girl, you're so unreal still. I keep loving you more and more each time. Girl, what am I gonna do? Cause you're blowing my mind. I get the same old feel. Every time you're here, I feel a change. Something moves. I scream your name. Look what you got to do with, darling. I can't get enough of your love, babe. Oh, no, babe. Girl, I don't know why. Can't get enough of your love, babe.
By insurancemarket.ae.
Diamonds are forever. They are all I need to please me. They can stimulate and tease me. Desert me. Diamonds are forever. Hold one up and then caress it. Touch it, stroke it and undress it. I can see every part. Nothing hides in the heart to hurt me. I don't need love. For what good would love do me? Diamonds never. sparkling round my little finger. Unlike men, the diamonds linger. Men are mere mortals who are not worth going to your grave for.
InsuranceMarket.ae now has over 20,000 Google reviews, the highest rated and the largest insurance platform in the country. InsuranceMarket.ae.
Life Talk 100.3.
Cinepolis Cinemas is now open in JVC at Circle Mall, Dubai. From the lavish luxury auditorium to the deluxe plus screens with wider plush seats, every detail is designed for your comfort. But wait, there's more. Cinepolis Cinemas has rolled out fantastic offers right at your fingertips. Avail exclusive discounts and bundled deals directly on their website or app. Booking your tickets is a breeze. Download the Cinepolis Golf app or visit cinepolisgolf.com to secure your seats hassle-free.
Right, it's 11:45. This is Ronak Kotecha, and we still have Dr. Bhushan with us, and we have some more questions coming in for him. So, Doctor, the one important question that is about oral cancer is also, what's the treatment like, and how difficult it can be for the patient?
Yeah, Ronak, even today, the frontline treatment for any oral cancer is surgery. So basically, we have to remove the tumor that is there. And then based on what type of tumor and what is the spread of the tumor, then the patients will be given radiotherapy and chemotherapy as and how dictated by the nature of the tumor. But the front line is surgery as of now.
Okay.
The difficulties that you mentioned is, one is when a patient hears the term cancer, they become very devastated.
Okay.
What I would like to mention here is, please don't be worried if you hear that word, because it is treatable as of now. Okay, and people are getting back to normal life. So one of the major indicators for any cancer treatment is quality of life. So we just don't remove the tumor. We have methods by which we can reconstruct the lost part, and even patients, we can rehabilitate them with teeth, okay, and they can get back to their normal life. Thoda time lagta hai, but they can resume their normal life. And we
so what's the success rate when it comes to oral cancer, like when it comes to fatalities, you know?
Fatalities are very rare from oral cancer per se.
Okay.
So if treated properly and the patients have a regular follow-up, and if the disease, if it comes back, is picked up early, it can be treated. And we've got patients who are, like I said, leading normal life even after 7 to 10 years of primary cancer surgery. So aisa nahi hai ki oral cancer ho gaya to sab khatam ho gaya. There is definitely a lot of hope and a lot of treatment options available.
Okay, but how about the facial disfiguration? Is that very high in as chances in oral cancer?
Thoda disfiguration hota hai, but one good thing is now we have something called as 3D printing technology. So isme hum kya karte hain, we take the patient's CT scan data, and then jo affected part hai, wo nikalne ke liye we have very precision guides which will help us in removing only the amount of tissue which is
required to be removed.
Okay. And also it is very good because we can take the data and print a plate or print a platform, okay, so that there is no facial asymmetry. This is made out of titanium. And what we do is we replicate the other side of the jaw. And using that information, we can print this 3D printed plates.
Wow.
And they are called as patient-specific implants. Pehle kya karte the? We used to take a stock implant and arbitrarily bend it to match the patient's face. So isme lot of discrepancy ho jata tha, and patients used to end up with higher asymmetry or deformity of the face. But with this 3D printing technology, which has come a big way in medical sciences, and it is helping us in the facial reconstructions also. And iske isse the surgery is more precise. There's no arbitrary treatment here. And then the patient can get back to their normal lives without much facial asymmetry or deformity.
Right. So when you say 3D printing, they print your skin as well? Or is it
mainly the jawbone, the supporting thing. And skin or iske liye, we have methods wherein we can take skin from other parts of the body, like your arm, and bring it with its own blood vessels and connect it to the blood vessels in the neck. So live skin rahega, and it mimics to a large extent the facial skin and this thing.
Right. So that becomes part of your job to grafting as well?
No, we do it as a part of a team which we have in NMC Royal DIP as well. So it involves the plastic surgeons also.
Correct. Yeah.
So we have onco surgeon, myself, the plastic surgeon. So it's a team of about 4 to 5 people. And that gives the best results.
One question has come in for you. They're asking, this is a question from Nia. She's asking, do you also see burn patients?
No, I don't do burns patient because burns goes purely under plastics. Yeah, the plastic surgery
All right.
people.
One more question is from Linthoy. She's asking, he or she, I don't know. Yeah. Do betel nut and betel leaf cause oral cancer?
Yeah, betel nut especially, more than betel leaf, has certain chemicals which we call as tannins, and they are implicated. One of the conditions which many people develop when they use betel nut is called as submucous fibrosis, which is very prevalent in our side of the world, like India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka. Basically, we have the propensity to develop this precancerous condition called as submucous fibrosis, jisme muh kholna mushkil ho jata hai. The mouth opening gradually reduces. And this is a condition which can easily lead to cancer, and this comes from betel nut chewing.
Okay, but only from there, or it can be there can be other causes as well?
No, the main thing for submucous fibrosis is major betel nut.
Good thing it's banned here, right?
Yeah, it is good.
Okay, and the good thing you just spoke about that, and Navneet is asking, I'm suffering from submucosal fibrosis. I can't open my mouth with 4-finger test. Do I need a surgery?
It depends. If your condition is under control and you are under regular follow-up, it is a reasonable mouth opening, then you don't need a surgery. But if it is very restricted mouth opening and there are some ulcers or white patches, then definitely you would need a surgical consultation, and then we can decide whether you actually need a surgery or you can be observed and
can be treated with medicines, maybe?
Yeah, treated with medicines. But the basic main thing is you need to stop betel nut chewing.
Okay. If at all. Not the person hasn't mentioned, but if at all.
Yeah.
And also then it begs the question, when should one see you directly?
One of the major areas is when you have any injury to the face. That is definitely wherein you need to come and see me. The other is if you have any ulcers or if you have any wounds or any
which
lumps.
Won't heal.
Which are not healing. Sometimes they are just because of a local trauma. So you take out the traumatic cause, it heals, then that doesn't require. But something that is not healing for, say, 10 days or 2 weeks, definitely needs further investigation.
But most of the times ulcers, they do heal on their own. Like for me, mouth ulcers, they always happen because I have an injury from a toothbrush, because I really brush very hard, which is also wrong. Because it, you know, it takes away the skin enamel and all that.
Yeah.
But now started using the electronic brush because of that.
That's good, yeah.
That's one of the common causes, right, for ulcers?
Yeah, that is one. Then we have something called as aphthous ulcers, wherein a lot of people who are very stressed out and they do get these aphthous ulcers. And as long as the ulcer is healing, then there's nothing to worry. But if it is not in healing, it's in the same place, you feel it's increasing in size, then that's something that you need to get checked.
It could mean cancer.
It could be. I mean,
See, the thing with cancer is that just the word itself, the C word, it's so scary for people that they don't, you know, want to get tested, but they don't want to know also, like, you know, because the life changes immediately with that one word.
Yeah, it's very good you brought this up, because one of the main things that we see is in patients is denial.
Right.
Bhai, mere ko kaise ho gaya?
Mere saath to nahi, kisi aur ke liye, mere ko nahi ho sakta.
This is not for me. So, I think denial is something which really, we see that the patients come to us at a stage when, if they had come a few months earlier, we could have taken much better care.
So this check once a year has to be done.
Yeah,
and what is the test that we have to do for oral cancer?
There's no specific test. A dentist, if they see everything is fine, the color of your gums is healthy, pink, and there's no white patches, no ulcers that are there for a long period. There are no white patches. So then just it's a clinical examination is fine. You don't need any specific tests.
Okay, well, we're completely out of time, but just last few minutes left. So quickly, if you can tell us that one case, that one landmark case that you remember.
Yeah, I mean... Yeah, I mean, it is one of the case which got published in Khalij Times recently. It was a young Filipino lady who... developed a swelling in the jaw and went to the dentist, but she was pregnant. And so the dentist said, we can't do any x-rays or anything. So they just left it. And after delivery, after a few months, she developed severe pain in the jaw. So she went to the dentist again and they did an x-ray, and she had a tumor which was going from one side of the jaw to the other side. And it was a big part of the jaw we had to remove. So we used this 3D printing technology, and we got a plate done, and then we used the bone from her leg, and we shaped it into a jaw, and we gave her some teeth. So it was a very good case, and she's back to her work now.
Very normal.
And, yeah, very normal, and it just took her about four and a half weeks' time.
To completely recover.
Yeah, and she doesn't look any... Greatly different. We did it all through one scar. Like, we didn't have to make multiple cuts. So she was very happy and very this thing. So it was a...
And was it all covered under insurance?
Yeah. Luckily, it was covered under insurance for...
Amazing. Yeah. Thank you so much, doctor. This was really, really informative.
Yeah. Thank you, Ronak. It was a pleasure talking to you.
Same here, doctor.
Thank you. This is Talk 100.3. We're caught in a trap. I can't walk out because I love you too much, baby. Why can't you see what you're doing to me when you don't believe? You can't.
BBC. The UN's highest court is due to make an initial decision today on a case brought by South Africa, which claims Israel is committing genocide in Gaza. The judges could order an immediate ceasefire, but they can't enforce the ruling. Israel has reacted with outrage to the genocide accusation. Large demonstrations have taken place across Australia, calling for the country's national holiday to be changed. January the 26th marks the arrival of European colonists in the 18th century. Many Indigenous Australians oppose its celebration. A senior US defence official has said Britain should reassess the strength of its armed forces. Carlos del Toro said the investment in the UK's naval forces was particularly important, given recent attacks by the Houthis on ships in the Red Sea. The number of foreign workers in Japan has topped 2 million for the first time. The country has been grappling with a severe labour shortage and an ageing population. South Korean politicians from across the political divide have condemned an assault on a governing party MP. Bae Hyun-jin was repeatedly struck on the head with a rock. Police say her assailant was a 15-year-old boy who may be suffering from a psychiatric illness. A group of women in Georgia who believe they're the victims of a black market adoption scandal are hoping to take their cases to court. Some of them were stolen at birth and sold. The trafficking network was uncovered by a journalist who wants the rights to access victims' birth documents. And in the past half hour, the men's world number one tennis player Novak Djokovic has been knocked out of the Australian Open. The 10-time champion was beaten by Jannik Sinner in the semi-final. It's the first time he's reached a major final. And that's the latest BBC News.
Fan Network News from the BBC. Put meaning into the day. This is Life Talk with Ronak Koteja, the smooth music mix and the best conversation across the morning. This is Talk 100.3.